50,000 people in jail because they are calling for fair demand, basic demand. In Bahrain we have more than 3,000.
A kind of mentality is this. Is a barbarian, is a killer, terrorist.
People want their place for justice, for human rights, for democracy.
Today and every day we will fight for self-determination and for return from behind.
We are put an end to tyranny, discrimination, and injustice in our Bahrain. But one day, ladies and gentlemen, one day longer, one year longer, and whatever. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm at the end of this ticket.
Free, free, Bahrain!
Down, down, Al Saud!
Down, down, Al Saud!
Free, free, Bahrain!
Free, free, Bahrain!
Down, down, terrorists!
Down, down, terrorists!
Of these companies, keep them in employment, getting the billions of arms, the Yamama project and the others would be by the prince to make the Saudi and the others interfere in the Saudi in our Bahrain. The gentlemen, the struggle goes on despite that. And we carry on and as one former American president, Lincoln Johnson was asked how long you can carry on your war in Vietnam, and he said it depends on the hearts and minds of the people. The use of live bullets against our civilized civilian population didn't stop us. The use of gas canisters being imported from Western countries and the Olympic shipment coming, we would have succeeded. We would have achieve victory against the regime who's been there since the British colonial legacy far there in Bahrain, over 200 years of suffering from that the ages of our martyrs, over 3,000. Our ages, our martyrs, ranging from babies as old as 10. The end of the hereditary regime of Al Khalifa in Bahrain. And once that regime falls, very
soon we go away, ladies and gentlemen. And we will remember, and we will be remembered how we stood up to dictatorship, how we stood up to discrimination, injustice in our Bahrain, brought to us by our father, by the British colonial legacy, and by the